Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and today we're going to be having a look at a Clefairy deck. Clefairy has the attack mini metronome, that says you flip a coin and if head you get to use the attacks of your opponent's active Pokemon. So today we're going to just try and be pulling this effect off on various decks we can find on the ladder, and we're going to be pairing this up with the Swanna we got from Darkness Ablaze that has the Feather Slice attack, I believe, that does 70 damage. And if you played Birdkeeper from your hand, if you discard an energy from this Pokemon, you get to do an extra 70 damage. And if you played Birdkeeper from your hand, you get to ignore all attack costs in this Pokemon's attack. So you kind of get a free attack in a way with Swanna. And we're just going to be aiming for like a counter box deck. You play Kangaskhan in this list also. It has the Rally Back attack that does 30 damage. And if you had a Pokemon KO'd in your last turn, you get to do 120, which is alright. And that's basically the deck, guys. We're just going to be trying to use Mini Metronome as many times as possible and try and make this deck work in the ladder. Before I get right into the ladder, remember to leave a like and subscribe for more content if you like this video. Without further ado, let's get right into some live battles. So guys, we found the matchup to go up against, and it looks as if our opponent is Mulligan, so let's see what we can pull off in this first turn. I'm not going to bench the Kangaskhan because I prefer to communication it back for another Pokemon. And it looks as if we're up against an Inteleon Metal deck. Anyways, this is the PTCG ladder for you. We're up against an ADP Inteleon deck, I think. So let's first up try and get up our Clefairy so we can copy its attack. We can't copy Altered Creation though, but you can copy the ultimate way if you really want to. We are just gonna grab the I really want to grab the Jirachi. Retreat into the Jirachi and just go for the Dreamy Revelation. Yeah, so we have what we need for next turn basically, and we can get down a Tyrogue, yeah, and we can just go for a Bat Kick and we miss it. But anyways, it's still a great way to end our turn. And next turn we have a Birdkeeper for next turn, so you can switch out this Jirachi. So we have a lot of possibilities for us to go for. So let's see what our opponent does to respond to our setup. So anyways guys, Shiny Fate is coming this Friday I think, so I'm really hyped for the set. What cards are you hyped to pull from the set? I'm really hyped for the Shiny Crobat and a bunch of other cards on the set. So it looks as if they pass back to us, and we are going to go for a Dreamy Revelation, get the Birdkeeper, and just go with the Birdkeeper and see what we get. We get a powerful colorless energy, so we can communication this back in. And just go with the Feather Slice. And we're just gonna discard the research. So I do 160, which is a great amount of damage to be doing turn 2. So I 2-hit KO in this ADP. and they play crushing hammers and they get tails, which is great for us. And we're also getting manied, so you can possibly join to some more cards to help us out in this matchup. And we still have the twin energy, and we can go for the bed keeper next turn, so we are carrying them no matter what. And they are just gonna go with decision, and they are going for altered creation, and we are just gonna bed keeper, I think. Yeah, we're gonna retreat. We're gonna go with the dreamy revelation, get a Kangaskhan down, and just the bed keeper back into the sauna. Oh, we're just gonna go with another feather slice and discard the research again, and we're gonna take 3 prize cards. So next turn we can Brave Blade decision if it doesn't set up in front of us quickly. But yeah, it looks as if they are trying to set up, and we're gonna get moneyed, but it's not too big of a deal. We're still in a pretty comfortable position right here, and we have another bed keeper for next turn. So we can retreat into our Jirachi again, go for a dreamy revelation. We can get under twin energy. You can see we are pretty comfortable with this deck, and I really liking how smooth it is so far. I'm just gonna thin out the deck in case we get reset stamped. We can draw out the Clefairy, attach your twin energy, and just go with the feather slice and discard the Elder Gods, because I don't really have anything to recover for next turn. So let's see what my opponent does to respond to this. They're probably just going to go into the station and Brief Blade us to take 2 prize cards, and hopefully we can hopefully get up the mini metronome off. If we can get it off this money. So it looks as if they are going for another Intrepid Sword, and they are gonna pass. And we are just gonna go with the money, because their hand is just huge at this moment. So let's see what we can do. I'm just gonna go with the Feather Slice. And not discard anything, just go for 70. And you're gonna take 2 prize cards. I get the Glimmer Tango for next turn. So you can hopefully get, if you can get a head here, that'll be phenomenal to wrap up this video. So they're just gonna take 2 prize cards here, and we are just gonna try and respond back with our mini metronome, see if we can get ahead here. Let's see, can we get ahead? Turn 1, and we don't get ahead, so that's gonna be a bust for us. They're gonna caution hammers us. So I think they're probably gonna discard the energy here. Probably just going to go into the bench position. And they can't really do, oh, they have a switch, and they're probably just gonna return the Brave Blade here. And we just really need to get ahead here. Oh, we're down just by 1-2 twin energy. So we just have to find a way to try and recover back from this. Let's see. You just need to get just one head off of here. Let's go with the Dreamy Revelation. You get another twin energy, and hopefully this time you can get a head. So we're gonna retreat and go with the mini metronome. We get tails, and we get tails again. Yeah, so this game is a bust. What's gonna scoop there? So let's go in white. Let's try to find if we can get another matchup to try and show Clefairy's potential a little bit more better if we can get ahead. So stay tuned, guys. So guys, welcome back. We found another matchup to go up against after game one. I'm not really sure whether Clefairy is really great in this deck as a whole, because we got like 4 Tails in a row off of Gilmo Tango, which is just ridiculous to think about. But anyways, hopefully we get better luck in this matchup. So let's see what my opponent is playing. It looks as if we're up against the Reshiram and Charizard deck. I don't want to attach the twin energy in case we get double blazed here. And they're probably gonna go with the double blazed GX here, just try and kill us. In hindsight, I should have gone into the I will take the dub. So let's see if we can find another matchup to try and showcase this deck a bit better on. So stay tuned, guys. Let me try and find a better matchup for me to showcase this deck. So guys, we found another matchup to go up against. Hopefully we can showcase Clefairy more. I was starting off with Clefairy, so hopefully we get ahead on the mini metronome this time. Let's see what my opponent is playing. So we're up against Mad Party, so Clefairy is gonna be kind of useless in this matchup because we can't really copy Mad Party. We don't have any Mad Partiers. I'm going to discard the Pokemon Communication, get a Ducklet, attach the Yuton board, and just communication back the Sona for a Kangaskhan because we really need it's in this matchup. And we're just going to go with the Dreamy Revelation and get the Great Catcher and just pass. So if they bench a Dedenne down here, we can just cost that up and just go with the Feather Slice and try and get a KO on that. So just going to go the Evolution Incense here. I think they are probably going to go with the Dedenne. So as expected, we can start chipping it right into the Dedenne, and they lose one triple acceleration energy, so they can only attack us 7 times now. Yeah, they only have 7 energy left in deck. And they plan down another research. Let's see what they go for. And they attach a twin energy to the Bonobi, and they are probably just gonna pick up the KO here. And we can just go into our Kangaskhan and reply back the KO. So they are discarding another Sinistry, and they don't even pick up the KO. So we can hopefully get a Swanna here. It could be great for us. I'm just gonna go with Bird Keeper right into the sauna, and we don't get it. So you are just gonna hold a hand. Can't believe we didn't even get KO off of the didn't get sauna off top of our deck, so it's not really time looking too great for us in this matchup. But we kind of still have the advantage because they bench down the Titani. And they bench down another Titani. And they lose another twin energy, so they are down by two energies now. Let's see. I'm not really sure what we can do particularly in this matchup. So we need to set up our sauna for next turn. And it looks as if they are really digging deep into their deck. They have like 13 cards left in deck and they lost most of their triple acceleration energy. We need to pick up 2 KOs this turn or the next. And they are really thinning out their Bonobies and loads of cards in their deck. They only have like 10 cards left in deck. Let's see. I'm just gonna get the Ducklet and Bird Keeper into the Kangaskhan to just pick up the KO. And we have what we need mainly for next turn. So yeah, I was gonna pick up the KO with the rally back attack. Let's see how our opponent responds to this. So next time we have a bird keeper, next time we have sauna and triple acceleration energy. So we're kind of evening out the KOs here. We still have the win condition of the Adidani. So they only have 5 cards left in the deck and they can't really do much here because let's see what we can do here. So we know that they are down by a bunch of energy and we just need to keep on flying back to the attacks with our own attacks. So you can grab a Kangaskhan here, yeah, and can attach the triple acceleration energy, go with the Dream Revelation, get down the under quick ball here, yeah, and just go with. We have 2 balls in the deck, so I don't really think we should be hunting down the Denny. Maybe we should. We are down by a bunch of our attackers here. Yeah, so I'm just gonna go with the Feather Slice into the Denny. Should we? Yeah, no. Yeah, so we're gonna reply back to Kale. We need our powerful causes energy here. We really need it a lot in this matchup. So they are going to go down to 3 prize cards remaining. And we need to shuffle back to and just go with the let's go with the research. I'll go with Dreaming Revelation. So we get what we need for next turn. So we are just gonna hold this hand. Yeah, I feel we'll just hold this hand. Alright, now they only have 3 cards left in their deck. Our next turn we can boss up the Dedenne and KO it from there. So this is gonna be a pretty close game. I'm just gonna go with Feather Slice. I don't really think you can win this matchup, so I was gonna scoop from there, and that's gonna be a wrap for today. So anyways guys, if you like this video, remember to leave a like and subscribe for more content, and yeah, I'll catch you guys next time. Peace out.